name is Kathy, and today I'll be teaching the Irish song, The Spinning Wheel Song, from the 50 Irish Melodies for All Harps book by Sylvia Woods. But before I do, I wanted to tell you that I have a great many videos now on many different topics, so I've decided to make several different video playlists so that it's easier to find the videos of greatest interest. So please check out my playlist page. The Spinning Wheel Song is a beautiful hypnotic melody that has enchanted listeners for more than 100 years. The song is in slow waltz time and has a rigid but gentle beat that seems to echo the foot movements of the girl operating the spinning wheel. Listeners talk about their minds drifting peacefully away as the song progresses. The song was written in 1884 by the Irish poet John Francis Wallet. Now I'll teach the easy version first and then the advanced version. Then I'll play the easy version with all of the elements discussed and then the advanced version. Hello! When learning this piece of music, clap and count out the right hand and the left hand, then learn it hands separately and then put it hands together. Now, all music tells a story, and I'm not talking about the words of the song. Rather, I'm speaking about the music itself. In The Spinning Wheel, the melody is in the right hand, and the accompaniment is in the left hand, so make sure that the right hand melody is louder overall than the left hand. Now, in all music, there's a beginning, an ending, and a climax point, and we'll discuss each of these elements now. In general, in music, it's a general rule of thumb that when the notes of the melody, in this case the right-hand notes, rise in pitch from lower notes to higher notes, that the volume will increase, and when the melody notes fall in pitch, the volume will decrease. In general, the left hand of most songs will be the spot where the beat of the song manifests most strongly. In general, the first note of each bar of music in the left hand is slightly emphasized to give a good strong beat, and the lower notes are also emphasized slightly, and what this does is it causes the playing of the piece of music to have greater depth and contrast. At the conclusion of the piece will be a slight retardando, or a slight slowing down of the tempo so that the listener can hear that the song is about to end. And this is the melody of the Spinning Wheel Song. Isn't that lovely? And this is the easy version of the Spinning Wheel Song. Thank you. Excellent. In the advanced version of the spinning wheel song, more notes have been added to the left hand to give a fuller sound to the piece of music. At the conclusion of the piece will be a slight retardando or a slight slowing down of the tempo so that the listener can hear that the song is about to end. In the advanced version of the spinning wheel song, there are broken 3 and 4 note chords on the second page, and I just in the right hand, and I just wanted to demonstrate how those fit in. Now, the first one occurs at the top of the second page, and the top of the chord fits in with the left hand, so it's I'll do it again. And a little faster. The same holds true with the 4-note chords as well. Great. And this is the advanced version of the spinning wheel song. Videos now on many different topics, so I've decided to make several different video playlists so that it's easier to find the videos of greatest interest. So please check out my playlist page. Well, that's it for now. To stay up to date with my latest videos, make sure to subscribe to this free YouTube channel by clicking the red subscribe button right below this video. Take care.